Hey, toy fans and collectors. So, if you followed the little first introduction video that I did for this series of videos called Redux or Redux, whatever you want to call it, it's basically going back to look at some of these vintage collection figures from Star Wars. But before we get into what you probably know as the TVC, we got to go back a little bit because what I'm talking about is all of the what looks like the original, the way back to the very first Star Wars figures. Now, I'm not going to cover them, the first 12 and then the first 21 and then collect all 92 or whatever it was in 86. Not talking about those vintage figures. I'm talking about what happened round about the early 2000s when Hasbro at that point decided, you know what, we have a decade we can plunder back on and re-release older figures. Why don't we do it? And these are the results of it. Now, there were some hits and misses, if you want to be exact about it. They did have at one point an early bird kit, a Walmart exclusive set, which didn't have any cards on it, but that actually came quite a year or so after. What came first was this. This wave, or this a range of figures, was called the Original Trilogy Collection. As we go through, what I'm going to do is deal with the figures generally in order that they first came out. So what we had first of all, right about 2004, was this, the Original Trilogy Collection, sometimes referred to as the VOTC, the Vintage Original Trilogy Collection. There's quite a few acronyms, so keep up at the back. But so what we're going to start off again, OTC or VOTC, whatever you want to call it, they're basically the same. Then we move on to what's called the Saga Collection, TSC. And then we move on to TVC, the Vintage Collection. So there's quite a few we've got to go through before we really get on to all of the vintage collection. The ones that I really wanted, I thought, let's try and cover most of these because I have nearly all of them on card, so we'll get a look at them. So a couple of figures here I'm going to show you and talk about the cards, talk about the figures. Now, some of these don't match. I don't necessarily always have a carded figure and a loose figure, or I might have a loose figure and a carded figure, but generally I've got it's all about the cards. It's all about the cardboard. So if you're brand new to here and you're not quite sure what the hell I'm on about, these are 3.75 inch or just under 4 inch Star Wars figures. And again, we're talking about all of the figures from my collection here that have the card represented that looks like the original Kenner, or if you're from the UK like me, Palitoy or Australia Tall Toys, whatever it may be, the re-release of these cards that started around the year 2000. You with me? I know, really confusing. I'll try and explain. Look, we'll have lots of questions. There'll be things along the way. Leave a note in the comments below, and we'll just try and answer your questions as good as we can. Going to try and take a look at maybe two or three figures per show. Otherwise, we'll be here till I'm dead. So we'll skim through these. So two figures here today, and this is again the OTC or VOTC V, which had 12 figures. Luke, Leia, Han, Obi, a Darth. I think I'm missing a Darth. 3PO, R2, Yoda, Lando, Chewie, R2, Boba, and a Stormtrooper. Again, we'll get to look at all of them, and they all came back out on these cards. So what we got was, in this case, 12 figures. Now, I can't remember the exact order, but they look, let's not get too detailed about it. 12 figures came back out. So let's look at Ben Kenobi, first of all, or Obi-Wan Kenobi. What we got here was a reproduction of the original art card. So there you go. There's on the back of it. There's the even prior to that version. And some text if you want to freeze frame. It'll talk about that, and it even gives you the year that originally came out, 78-79. But this release here was the 2004, again, OTC or VOTC. You're going to be sick of seeing it by the time I'm finished. These were unpunched, beautifully produced cards. I can't recall whether these guys came in a clamshell or not. I think they might have, I can't remember. Anyway, this guy was pretty flawless. The only problem with this card was it had a very faded kind of cover on it. Now, they may have tried to reproduce the original kind of art there, but I don't remember it looking quite as bad as this. There's something not quite right about the color balance mix in the card or the card stock. And that's the same for the figure because look at the color of his skin. Very weird. So I don't have a loose figure for this. But underneath there was pretty similar to what I do have, one which was even better. But what we did get here was a very fuzzy kind of jacket, as you can see, his overall kind of jacket there. A little bit limited in articulation. It wasn't great. We did get a very blue lightsaber. You can see that on the figure there. But then we did get some articulation. Got peg holes. We got a cloth skirt at the bottom. But that face, though, I mean, puts Donald Trump to shame. Look at the pinkness on there. I mean, wow. So something's not quite right on there. And, you know, it wasn't the greatest facial sculpt ever. And it was a so-so kind of figure. But again, at the time, I just bought a carded one. I didn't buy a loose one. So let me review it. If you're really, really desperate, you'll find a review. There's a little shot of him outside the pack there. The soft goods were very bouffant and very big and puffy. But a good figure nonetheless. Han Solo's there too. Probably the finest figure, I think, in the VOTC line, or even to date in the vintage collection. He's one of the strongest figures ever. Leia, which we'll cover as well, and Luke, which we'll cover too. So, and there's all of the figures in this wave, the VOTC or OTC wave, these figures. And what they've done, as you can see, is 4 from A New Hope, 4 from Empire, 4 from Jedi. So that's Obi-Wan on the card. What I've done here, just for a quick comparison, is I took a more modern release of Obi-Wan as my preferred one carded, one display kind of figure. And as you can see, he was much better and Hasbro improved over the iterations of him, not only in the facial sculpt, but the facial colour. So we really did get a much better looking cape overall, facial sculpt, hair looked right. So it was a much better figure overall. We even got on this release, and I can't remember which one this was. I think it was the 30th anniversary collection, but it was one of these. Come on, we're going to get some camera issues. This actually had a wire in the cape, which was a nice little feature. Couldn't quite find it doing some research for the show. I can't remember. If you know, let us know. Leave a note in the comment. I've got a funny feeling it was either 30th anniversary, something like that. I can't recall. But anyway, pretty good, solid lightsaber. And again, articulation pretty standard for the time. Head was pretty simple on a kind of peg joint up there. Shoulders, ball joint, a single joint at the elbows. And we got a kind of swivel at the wrists there. And I don't think there was any more articulation on that hand, was there? Maybe? I couldn't quite see up there. Nope, it looks as if it was just a little peg joint. And we got some waist articulation. And having a look at the other underneath all this crazy amounts of fabric, you could see really a swivel up at the top, ball joint at the knees, and that was pretty much it, down to a rocking ankle. So pretty simple, but decent articulation. And at the time, I remember just thinking, this is the mutt nuts, this thing. This is awesome. So a really good-looking figure. Even had what eventually we got in the 6-inch collection as a kind of hook for your lightsaber, although it didn't really happen on this lightsaber hilt here. This is all one piece from memory, so all one non-detachable piece on the lightsaber hilt, but still beautifully done on the hilt. Lots of nice details in the saber overall. So he was a good figure, but again, it wasn't this one here, so I really shouldn't spend too much time on it. But yeah, let's pass on him. He was a bit rubbish. We'll look at eBay and Amazon in just a minute to see about getting these figures, what they roughly go for, to give you a bit of a buyer's guide. Stands that I've got in these figures are my own. Again, I've talked about them before, but I'll put a link under the description along with links to buy these guys too. This was just a little trinket which came with another figure. Again, I think, I can't remember. And if you know, I'd love if you could tell me. I can't remember what figure this came with, but it was a really nice little piece. I think it came with a Luke Skywalker or something, or an Obi, but it was a little piece here. And that's Obi-Wan's Starfighter helmet, microphone in there. We've got something that's his mouth breather, I think, from the Phantom Menace. The little training ball from A New Hope. We got a little slot for lightsabers there. I think it's a Darth lightsaber, Luke's lightsaber. And that kind of popped out. And again, you're going to kill me, but I can't remember what set that came with. Someone out there is going to tell us. So leave a note in the comments and let us know. I've probably reviewed this over the past. I have something like 2,000 reviews on the channel. So just forgive me if I don't remember every single thing, okay? But it was a nice little set. And that's how I display my figures, is generally one carded, one loose. And I like the little extra that the figure came with. That's Obi. We'll come and talk about him in a minute in terms of getting prices for him and what you should be doing with that. In terms of Han Solo, my God, this was one of the finest cards ever released, and figures too. When I used to do the Born Conversation Anyway podcast, which is still limping along slowly, we are getting there to try and do some more, but the original co-host, and I used to rave about this whit, and I used to just this was the best figure ever for us. It was just fantastic, and it's a really good Han Solo, and we'll get a look at that in just a second. So again, going back to that classic card, Star Wars Han Solo on there. Got that green element, which was the original green on there. Now, you had two variations way back in the olden days. You can dig out some old books and find out some stuff. Steve Sansweet made some action figure archives if you want to go back and look at these old figures. But there was Fathead Han and Small Head Han. I definitely preferred Small Head Han, which I think is pictured there. Yes, it is. Much better figure, personally. But were you Fathead Han or Small Head Han? Leave it in the comments. Let us know. So that was 70-79. Again, this was 2004, and there's the rest of the figures again, or some of them, from this wave that the Hasbro released to collect all 12. Beautiful card, though. Again, just Harrison Ford in his prime, Han Solo, cool as hell. Really, really good. And again, that was unpunched too. So, which reminds me, again, I'm sure these were in a clamshell, weren't they? I can't recall. So this was the figure underneath it all. This was the figure that we absolutely adored. And I think it was just because the facial sculpt, whilst not absolutely Harrison Ford, it was just, it didn't look stupid. AKA that. So, you know, it looked like a real figure. It kind of looked like Harrison Ford. It had a really nice kind of sculpt on it. It looked like him a little bit here and there. But there was something about the aesthetic. It was just really nicely done. We get some nice detail on the belt. His trousers look good. Boots look good. The proportions were right. That was one thing which I always really liked about it. You know, we talk about Fathead Han way back in the 70s. They got the proportions of the head and the body right. As they even went along in the vintage collection, Hasbro made some weird choices about heads for Han Solo and gave him odd heads in different sizes. So they never really quite got it right. So it was a little bit frustrating to think that one of the older figures here was the classics, and they still couldn't quite improve upon it. So I'm dying to see what they do in the vintage collection when they re-release this guy, because they will, and they will definitely do that, so don't you worry. So there is no removable vest jacket, which actually isn't a problem. It's kind of all stuck on to the molded in and sculpted into the figure. But that belt was really good in its proportions. It sat really nicely. Perhaps a little slim in the legs and a little thin, but great poses out the figure. And again, standard articulation. The ball joints here and there, the single joints at the shoulder, swivel at the wrists. It all just worked in little swivel hips there. And again, no boot cut, but pretty simple stuff. But we could get some really good poses out of hand and just, you know, make them look that kind of original poses we have on the card. That's what we wanted, and that's what we got, and this figure did not disappoint. So that's one of my absolute favorite figures, and again, I don't think I ever properly, for some reason, got to give that a proper review. So there you go. We finally got to give it a proper review. I think we talked about it so much, or it came out just after I started doing reviews and podcasts way back in about 2005, I think it was. So there you go, and this was probably one of the figures that helped me get into doing some reviews. So this figure's got a lot of history behind it. Really, really good figure. But let's take a look at some of these figures in terms of what they're available for in costs these days. So what I'm going to do in just a second, as I log in here, I'm going to show you, and we'll blow up in size. Let's take this round here. What we'll do is let's get a look at Obi-Wan first of all. There's two places that you can really go to look at figures. Don't worry, I'm going to zoom in just a second. What you can really do is you can go to eBay, which is probably the best place to go and have a look at these things. And the best thing I would suggest is on the left-hand side of your menu is sold items. And that is the place to find out basically how much a figure is worth. So that's what you need to do. So let me just zoom in there again a little bit. So you can see that some lucky get picked up, well, it is horrible looking facial sculpt and pink face, but $4.25 someone picked up. Now, everything we talk about here is in US dollars. So just do your conversion in Google. Just put the USD to GBP or to AUD or whatever your currency is in your country, the three digits normally. So you can see, you know, and then I've sorted this as well here on the price and shipping. So you can get from a couple of bucks up to $9, $15, $10, $15. So really, this figure's pretty damn cheap. He is pretty cheap overall. Now, there's one that's actually got what it looks like not too bad in terms of the paintwork on him. He doesn't seem to be quite as bad. So again, paint can vary. Let's see if we can get maybe a picture of that. Yeah, not too bad. It doesn't look quite as harsh as the one that I've got on the card. But, you know, a used figure, and, you know, if you wanted it, it's not so bad. Time obviously takes a toll on these figures, without a doubt, because the weather can really eat into them, bright light can eat into them, and just oxidization, I should say, of the figures really causes things to change. So paint can be an issue. In terms of Amazon, I had a quick look there to see what is on for Obi-Wan. Again, pretty damn cheap. So you can pick this guy up there. Oh, it's sold. There was one up there for $14.99, I think it was. Or did I open the second one? There you go. So this looks like a loose one, I think, potentially $14, $15. Someone, of course, is trying to fleece everybody on Amazon there for a pretty shocking, I think it's $58.89 on that one. So there you go. Again, I'll put links to these in the description below under the video. So you can just click them, you can just go to Ben and buy it if you want. Now, for Han, let's do the same thing as I scroll down. Best thing to do is if I go to sold items and completed items on the left-hand side, you'll see it changes in just a second. And there we go. Absolute steal. Somebody got one for $4. That's just terrible. So, although not a lot of people did. Well, there's $7.50. That was back in January, early January. And some other hands in there, which were really not great. We're looking for that one that we just discussed and talked about. So yeah, that was kind of rare to get that. I think, oh no, $8.80. There's maybe somebody accepted a best offer, maybe $15, $10, $10, $8, $12. Wow, pretty cheap actually. That's a lot cheaper than I thought it would be. There's some other figures that we'll talk about. So yeah, it looks like a kind of $8 to $10 if you're in the US was roughly the cost of this guy. So that's not too bad. That's a pretty reasonable price overall. On Amazon, he was going for, I think, where did we have him? Over here. There we go. $20. So, you know, that's not terrible. So a slightly different price going for that figure. But yeah, it depends. So really, as our first figures that we look at, these two didn't fare too badly in terms of how much they're costing these days. These are pretty cheap. So to get a classic original Han Solo on this, well, not original, but the reproduction of them, and a great figure, $20, $15, something like that. Again, we'll put links below. Tell us what you think. The these two figures, without a doubt, I believe they'll be re-released in the vintage collection again. So I think in terms of me, I'm going to hang on to the Han Solo, but I think it's time to let Ben go. I think I think we're going to get a better one, so I think it's time he passed on. That's it for me. Luke, I did promise this would be a lot of meaty kind of regurgitating at the vintage collection. We'll try and move a little bit quicker at the next one, but let us know what you think of our Redux below. Leave a comment. I'm sure you know the drill, do all the rest of the stuff, and we shall see you for episode 2 for more of these.